несоблюдение другого приводит к опустошению огромных пространств, ликвидации жизненных условий для своего народа, тоже является гибелью. Все кризисы, все конфликты сегодняшнего дня, источником их является опять-таки несоблюдение индивидуальных прав и коллективных прав. Поэтому эти вопросы должны быть из прерогативы внутренних вопросов определенного государства, каким бы он ни был великим, даже таким, как Китай, должен стать центром внимания нашей организации, организации ООН и всего демократического статуса. То есть за внимание.
Absolutely no room for cultural development. A man who successfully controls you and all of your people. Another point, I'm speaking from the perspective of the indigenous people, is tribal law. And I think that you will find that if you examine traditional tribal law of the indigenous people, it is very compatible to Western law. I think so.
By the international community. And I think that we can start, at least regionally, this process of mutual recognition. If we recognize each other and if we invite delegations, very good. This is my first proposal. As far as the CSC process, as we know, High Commissioner for National Minorities has been established. His major function is early warning function. And so I propose, why not establish early warning system within the in the UNPO, so that we could, through UNPO, submit the cases of pending flaring up of hostilities. Perhaps it could be more effective than to do it, to communicate individually with the High Commissioner for
Thank you. Why to condemn a woman which gave birth to the noble